I will tell you how the devil turned a good friend of mine into a betrayer. Have you ever felt betrayed by a friend or by someone you dearly loved? When it happened, were you shocked? Did it feel like that person put a knife in your back by violating your trust and revealing things that should have been kept in confidence? Did you ever think that such a trusted friend could turn out to be so disloyal? Did you ever wonder, how in the world could a person so dear and close to you be used so viciously by the devil to attack you in that way? It's painful when a friend betrays you. It's even worse when the person is your best friend or someone you've known and trusted for many years. Betrayal is something that happened to people since the beginning of times. It's simply a fact that the devil is a master at distorting and ruining relationships. Then he coaches them to nurture their offense until it mutates into strife that separates even the best of friends and families. Don't forget, Satan was kicked out of heaven because of his unique ability to create confusion, discord, and strife. Heaven is as perfect as an environment can be, yet in that perfect environment, the devil was still able to affect 1/3 of the angels with his slanderous allegations against God. Angels who had worshipped together for aeons of time now stood opposed to each other over issues the devil had conjured up in their minds. That should tell you how clever the devil is at creating discord and strife. If a devil is persuasive enough to do this with angels, think how much easier it is for him to deceive people who live in a far from perfect environment and who wrestle daily with their own imperfections and self-images. Satan watches for that opportune moment when a person is tired, weary, or exasperated. Then he waits until someone does something that person doesn't understand or agree with. Suddenly, it is as if the devil shoots a fiery arrow of rage straight into the person's emotions. Before long, strife, bitterness, unforgiveness, and division begins to mount. Friends who once stood side by side and cherished each other now stand facing each other as hostile rivals. If this sounds familiar, be encouraged. This same scenario happened to Jesus. After working with Judas Iscariot for 3 years, the devil found his way into Judas' soul, turning him so sour against Jesus that this disciple became his betrayer. But we need to ask, what opened the door for this deception to occur inside Judas? What was the exact moment that Satan put his thought into Judas's heart? It is important that you learn how to recognize those times when the devil tries to inject a seed of division into your heart. He wants to drive a wedge between you and the people you love. Rather than let him get away with this evil tactic, make a decision to resist every temptation to get angry and offended. By resisting these thoughts, you can take a stand against the devil and protect your relationship. And I want to pray for all of you today who have been attacked by Satan through a good friend that betrayed you. Lord, Please forgive me for the times I have allowed the devil to put a wedge between me and the people you have placed in my life. Help me go to them and ask forgiveness for the things I did wrong. Help me also to extend patience, forgiveness, and love to others who have done wrong to me or who will wrong me in the future. I never want the devil to be in charge of my emotions or my thoughts or my life. So I'm asking you to help me think clearly and to know how to recognize those times when the devil tries to upset me and ruin my relationships. I pray this in the name of Jesus. And let's confess to the Lord. I confess that my mind is free of offense, unforgiveness, and strife, because I walk in mercy and forgiveness. The devil has no entrance or open door to find his way into my mind and emotions. The Spirit of God dominates my thinking and helps me see things very clearly. I declare this by faith in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.